কোন বলছো? আচ্ছা, গুড মর্নিং বেটা।
গুড মর্নিং টিচার।
সো উই হ্যাড ফিনিশ দিস স্লাইড, সো জাস্ট রিপিট ইট ওয়ান্স অ্যাগেইন দ্যাট উই হ্যাড বার্ন দ্য ম্যাগনেসিয়াম স্ট্রিপ। First, we cleaned it with a sandpaper, and with the help of candle flame, we burnt one end of it, and we got a brilliant white light, and the ash fell on the floor. That powdery ash does not look like magnesium wave, isn't it? So it is an irreversible change. So this is a chemical change, and this is the equation. The chemical reaction that took place is this equation, that magnesium in presence of oxygen is burning. Magnesium oxide, which is ash. What it is, beta? Ash. Is this clear? Now, what we are going to do with magnesium oxide, we will see in the next slide. Now, we will take that ash. What we will do, beta? We will take the ash. Please read, one of you. Hello, please read, one of you. Should I carry on? Okay. I will take the ash, okay, and mix it in water. What you get? Another new substance. The new substance, you can write it like this. What was the ash better? Ash was magnesium oxide. What is the ash? Magnesium oxide, which we burnt with the help of candle flame. Then I will put it in water and dissolve it in water. What I will get? Magnesium hydroxide. This is a new substance. Remember that. This is a new substance that we got when we dissolved it in water. Is this clear? You have to learn all these things, all the equations you have to learn. Boys, do you understand or not? Hello? Boys, do you understand? Hello, can you hear me? Hello? Boys, can you hear me, beta? Hello? Same thing. Please, one of you read, beta. Please read, one of you. This is how it looks like. See, when you're burning this magnesium strip, this is how it looks like. One of you start reading better. Burning of magnesium ripple. Boys, can you hear me? Can you hear me? Hello. Hello. Hassan, can you read better? Can anyone read the slide? Hello. Hear me better? Ibrahim? Can you hear me better? you see over here, a strip of Mangesh ribbon in a heating over flame. Now, how does it burn in presence of oxygen? It gives out white light and forms powdery ash, which is known as magnesium oxide. The reaction is like this: Mg plus O2, we get MgO, that is magnesium oxide. Now next is, this magnesium oxide, this MgO, is put in water and we get a new substance, this is called magnesium hydroxide. Now what is the property of magnesium hydroxide? It is basic. Why? Because the red liquid will turn to blue, showing that it is basic in nature. The reaction that you see over here is magnesium oxide, this one that you had got as powdery ash. We mix it with water and we get magnesium hydroxide. Now, how does magnesium hydroxide looks like? You can see over here. It is MgOH2. Is this clear? Boys, is this clear, Bita? Can you hear me? First tell me that. Children, can you hear me? 7th standard? Hello? Boys, can you hear me, Bita? The next activity is 6.7. We will take copper sulfate. Now, copper sulfate is also known as blue vitriol or nila thotha. This is the names, this is the synonyms of copper sulfate. It is also called as blue vitriol or nila thotha. I take a half cup of water. Okay? And dissolve this teaspoon of copper sulfate. When you make a mixture, then add few drops of sulfuric acid. Now, sulfuric acid is H2SO4. Now, this is concentrated. What I will put? I will put a little bit of water to make it dilute. So, what I do for dilution, I add water. So, you will add dilute sulfuric acid to this copper sulfate solution. Let's see what happens. See over here. Copper sulfate solution is blue in color. Then I will add iron to it. Okay, so what it will become? Iron sulfate. What it will become, Beta? Iron sulfate. As soon as it becomes iron sulfate solution, the blue color will turn to green. And on that iron, you will see this brown color deposit of copper. You understand now? So you can see the chemical reaction has taken place. You can see over here, this is copper sulfate solution, which is blue in color. And then you have put a blade here at the bottom. You see this blade? This will have orange color deposits of copper on it. And this color will become green, showing that the reaction has taken place. Have you understood? Boys, have you understood? The same thing textually we are going to do. The reaction between copper sulfate and iron. Last time we had taken blade, now we will take nails. We will again dissolve a bit of copper sulfate in a beaker and we'll add dilute sulfuric acid, right? Which color solution we will have? Blue color solution. Then we'll put a nail. What we'll put better? We'll put nail or a blade into it. After some time, see the color of the nail. Say after half an hour or an hour, what you will see? A bit of brown deposition of copper. You can find over nail or the blade that you put inside. And also, the solution color will change from blue to green. Why? Because due to chemical reaction, now copper sulfate was present earlier. It's copper sulfate, copper is replaced by iron to become iron sulfate. This is a displacement reaction, and we get a green color from blue color. The reaction that you can see over here is copper sulfate, iron. Cu is copper, and SO4 is sulfate, copper sulfate. Fe is iron. What we get? Iron sulfate. Fe is iron, SO4 is sulfate, and Cu is copper. Cu, we got it on nails. Where we got it? On nails. Deposition on nails. What you see over here? This is blue copper sulfate solution. This is blue copper sulfate solution. And we have put the nail inside this copper sulfate solution. After half an hour, the same color will change to blue color, will change to green color. So we have got green iron sulfate solution, and we have got copper metal on iron, copper deposition on iron. Is this clear? Hello? Is this clear, Vita? Now we'll do another activity. Take a test tube and put a little bit of vinegar into it. What is vinegar? It is acetic acid. Vinegar you use in Chinese food item.
Yes,
and also
so.
In pickles. Hello? What did you say, Vita? Hello? You want to ask me something? And then to this vinegar, you put a pinch of baking soda. So what we are doing, we are adding vinegar and baking soda. What you will see? You will see that bubbles are coming out. And there's a hissing sound, like how a snake does. And this gas, you have to pass through lime water. What do you have to do? You have to pass through lime water. And now the question is, what will happen to the lime water? Now, should I ask you the question? What is this gas coming out? What is the type of gas? Can you tell me what is the gas which is coming out when you are adding a pinch of baking soda to vinegar? What is coming out as a gas? Can anyone tell me? It is carbon dioxide. What is coming out? Do you take colas, Bitter? Do you drink colas? Sodas? Hello? Do you take soft drinks? Hello? Boys, do you take soft drinks, Bitter? When you open it, open the cork, you get that froth coming out, a foam sort of thing coming out with a hissing sound. Have you ever observed that? All this gas is due to carbon dioxide. The carbon dioxide present with the pressure inside this liquid makes the hissing sound and the foam which comes out of the bottle. It's only due to the presence of carbon dioxide gas. Let's see what happens to lime water. See over here. In this test tube, what we have? Vinegar plus baking soda. Right, Beta? So a reaction is taking place. A chemical reaction is taking place. I've got a bent tube. What I have, Beta? I've got a bent tube. You can see this. This is called as bent tube. Which gas is liberated? Carbon dioxide is liberated. CO2. Which gas is liberated? Carbon dioxide is liberated. and it is in the lime water. So you will see that this lime water will become milky. Why? Due to the presence of calcium carbonate, CaCO. Is this clear? Is this clear? Hello. Now we see the theoretical part of the reaction between vinegar and baking soda. First, you have to take some vinegar in a test tube, and then you have to add a little bit of baking soda. I think you know where do we use baking soda, Vita? We use baking soda to make all bakery items. We're making bread, making cake. Yes, anything which fluff, which becomes fluffy, will have this baking soda. Okay, Vita? So, when you add this baking soda to vinegar, suddenly reaction starts and you can see bubbles coming out with a hissing sound. The gas which is formed due to this chemical reaction is carbon dioxide. So what it is? Vinegar, which is known as acetic acid, and baking soda, which is known as sodium hydrogen carbonate, when they unite, when they react, it liberates carbon dioxide and other substances. We are not interested in other substances, we are interested in carbon dioxide. Now, this carbon dioxide gas is passed through lime water. So the lime water will turn milky. Why? Because calcium carbonate is formed, showing that the gas which is liberated in the first test tube is carbon dioxide. Is this clear? Is this clear, Vita? The reaction that follows is this. Carbon dioxide, calcium hydroxide, lime water, we get calcium carbonate, the CaCO3, and water. Is this clear? All these chemical reactions you have to learn according to the topic. Do you understand? You start learning the chemical formula. Now there is a process, a chemical reaction I'm talking about, that you see rusting of iron. Sometimes you see a paint, a shining paint on a metal. The shining paint on a metal is called as galvanization. It's a process by which you get a shiny texture, glossiness of the surface of the metal is due to galvanization. What is it exactly? The layer which is deposited. Which is layer? It's a layer of a metal. Which metal? Chromium or zinc. On what? On iron. Why are we doing so? So that we are protecting iron from rust. If you don't cover iron, the iron surface will get oxidized. Oxidation is called as rusting process. So we are increasing the life of iron metal by galvanization process. Is this clear? Yes? So why galvanization? Because of rusting of iron. And what is rusting of iron? Let's see. Now whenever any iron material gets rusted, is damaged. For example, you got furniture made up of iron. You got almirahs made up of iron. If it gets rusted, there will be a hole. It gets corroded, and the metal will be damaged and may create holes in the almirahs. So, why is this happening? Because of a reaction. It's a reaction between iron and oxygen, which is present in the atmosphere, along with the water vapor. Remember that. If there is no water vapor in the atmosphere, rusting will not take place. Is it understandable? Rusting will not take place. Okay? So, presence of water, presence of oxygen, and the iron material is a must for the rust to form. Is it understandable, beta? Yes? Let's see what is rust. See over here, iron reacts with oxygen. In presence of water vapor, we get iron oxide. Now, what is the other name of iron oxide? Rust. If I say it is rust, what exactly is rust? It is iron oxide. The same way what we had done in magnesium. When we burned the magnesium ribbon, we got magnesium oxide. That was in the form of ash. Is this clear? Yes. So how can you prevent this? Then the galvanization comes. First at home. Now you cannot keep on galvanizing all the iron atoms. It is expensive. So what is the easy way of preventing rust? First is you apply oil or grease. So when you just put a layer of oil and grease on the iron material, the rusting may stop. Second is paint the iron substances. So you have to apply paint. Third, just now we talked about coating a layer of metals like zinc or chromium on iron. That is called galvanization. Have you understood? So what is this? It's a phenomena, it is the process by which a chromium or nickel coating is made on iron. This process is called as galvanization. Why are we doing so? So as to prevent rusting of iron. Is this clear? Can any of you start reading better? I'm a bit tired now. Can one of you start reading? Hello? Can one of you start reading better? Next is crystallization. Please start reading better. Are you reading or not? Hello? Hello? Start reading, beta. Big crystals of substances. That means those crystals are pure crystals. Remember that. You can make it from their solution. So, first we make solution. And then we evaporate it and we get pure crystals. This process is called as crystallization. What is this called, beta? Crystallization. Now, this is an example of physical change. Right, beta? Hello? We do it again as a part of revision. The process of obtaining large crystals of a pure substance from a solution is called crystallization. How to prepare the crystals? Let's see. We'll take some water in a beaker. What we'll do it up? First, we'll take a beaker, add some water to it. Then we'll put dilute sulfuric acid to it. Warm the water. When the water starts boiling, you have to add copper sulfate, but not crystal form, but powder form, slowly. And keep on stirring the solution so that you can see that there's no powder. Okay, so you have to get the saturated solution. What do you have to get better? Saturated solution. That means you cannot dissolve any more powder, copper sulfate. Then what you will do? You filter the solution and then let it cool. Later, what you will see? Pure crystals of copper sulfate are formed. See this. This is powder. What is this better? Powder copper sulfate. SO4 powder form. Is this clear? This is powder copper sulfate. Then what we do? We dissolve it in water. So it's got a blue solution. Do you see this better? This is blue solution. So we keep on stirring, right, Peter? Then later we get this sort of crystals. This is pure crystals we got. These are the crystals, right? These are pure crystals. Any problem? We have seen the physical changes and chemical changes. Now we are going to check by the questions that have been put forth whether we know or understand physical changes, or we can distinguish physical from chemical changes or not. Let's see. Classify the changes involved in the following processes as physical or chemical changes. Right? Photosynthesis, what is that, Peter? It is a chemical change. What is photosynthesis? Chemical change. You are dissolving sugar in water. You are making sugar solution. What is it? What is it? Physical change. But it is chemical change as well because it is becoming sugary. Right? When you taste it, it is sugary. So it is a chemical change as well. Burning of coal. You get ash, so it is a chemical change. Melting of wax. What is it? Melting of wax. Again, you can make a candle out of it, so it is a physical change. Heating aluminium to make aluminium foil. Aluminium is the same. You don't get a new substances. When you get a new substance, then it is a chemical change. When you don't get a new substance, it is a physical change. So aluminium remains aluminium. It is a physical change. Then we have got digestion of food. You eat something and it keeps on getting digested. Then it is called a chemical change. Is this clear? Is this clear better? Next question. When you are adding baking soda with lemon juice, bubbles come out. What is the change? What is the change? So when baking soda, you are mixing with lemon juice, bubbles which comes out by the chemical reaction that is happening over there is of carbon dioxide gas. So a new substance is formed. You is chemical reaction. So it is a chemical change. Carbon atom is formed, so it is a chemical change. Now let's take a candle. You are burning a candle. What sort of change will you see? When you are burning a candle, what sort of change can you see? We can see both changes, physical as well as chemical changes. Why physical? Why physical change? Because the candle was long. When we are burning the candle, it becomes short. So that's a physical change, right, Becca? And chemical changes. What is chemical changes? It is burning in presence of oxygen. So chemical reaction is taking place. There is a chemical change as well. So the melting of wax is physical change because wax is wax. And the burning of wax is chemical change because due to that we are getting the flame on the candle. You understood? Let's take another example as cooking of food. When you are cooking food, both changes are observed, physical as well as chemical. Why? Because when you are cooking raw vegetables, chemical changes take place. Water in the vegetable changes into steam, which is a physical change. So water when changes to steam is a physical change, but when vegetables are being cooked, it is a chemical change. Because you should know that vegetables are all made up of chemicals. We are also made up of chemicals. Is this clear? Is this clear? Hello? Now, what about curd? Why curd is called as chemical change? Now, when curd is formed from milk, you cannot change it, you cannot reverse it, because from curd you cannot get milk. So it is irreversible change. Now, a formation of new substance has taken place with different properties. It's irreversible, so it is a chemical change because a new substance is formed. So it is a chemical change. From milk we got curd, so it is a chemical change. Now let's talk about burning of wood. When you are burning wood and you are cutting into small pieces, there are two different types of changes. So when you are burning the wood, it is a chemical change. And we are making the wood into small pieces, it is a physical change. Because when you are burning wood, it changes to ashes, which is a new substance. And from ash you cannot wood, so it is irreversible. So a new substance is formed, which is a chemical change. And when you are cutting the wood, small pieces, no new substance is formed, so it is a physical change. Now they are asking to how crystals of copper sulfate are formed. We have always seen that better by the method of crystallization. What you should do first step, take water in a beaker, right better? Second step, add dilute sulfuric acid to it. Third step, heat the water. And when it starts boiling, you have to add powdered copper sulfate slowly while stirring. Keep on adding till no more copper sulfate crystals get dissolved. Is this clear? Later, you have to filter this solution and allow it to cool without any disturbance. Okay, and after some time what you see that big crystals of copper can be observed on the petri plate or in the beaker. Is this clear? This clear, Vita?
Yes.
Now we come to galvanization. that how painting of an iron gate prevents it from rusting. Just now we talked about it. Painting prevents iron gate from rusting. Why? Because it is making a barrier between the iron and the atmosphere. So it is cutting the direct contact of iron from the environment. So the iron is not exposed to oxygen, which is present in the environment or atmosphere, as well as moisture, because both should be present for rusting, moisture as well as oxygen. So what are we doing? We are making a barrier. We are making a cover of a metal layer so that the iron will not have a direct contact with the atmosphere. So oxygen and water vapor will not be available to it, and it will protect it from rusting by the galvanization process. Now, another question is that why rusting is more in coastal areas as compared to desert? I think you should know the answer. Iron objects get rusted. Why? Because of the reaction with oxygen, which is present in moist air. Okay, so what is must? Oxygen, iron, and water vapor. So in coastal areas, you should know that moisture is maximum, because we have sea and ocean. Whereas if you talk about desert, there is no water vapor and the air is dry and very hot. Therefore, rusting of iron objects is more or faster in coastal region as compared to desert. Is this understandable, Bita? Yes? Is this understandable? We have come to the close of the chapter, Bita, regarding the physical and chemical changes. I try to use so many questions to make you understand all the features. So here we have talked about galvanization, crystallization with the means of questionnaires. I hope you have understood nicely. I'm a bit disappointed. I thought that one of you will start reading, but no one took up the charge. I don't know why. I hope you will not do it again. Yes, boys.
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Why you did not take up reading with her today?
Hello.
Yeah, hello. Why you did not take up reading?
Zohair Abbas.
Is that you, Zohair Abbas?
Yes.
Why you did not read today?
Ma'am.
Yes?
I didn't say my name. Fazil has said my name.
Why?
He is making mischief.
Okay. I see to it that he does not do it again. Okay, Zohair, were you present in the class since beginning?
Yes.
Why you did not read?
Because I was not able
to read. What happened? You're tired?
So much disturbance.
Where?
In my house.
I'm sorry, I'm really sorry. You mean guests are around?
No, but my brother and my mother was making him ready to move to tuition.
Okay, I can understand. Fine. Because, see, I read out everything. I was shocked because it tires me, you know. I'm having lectures since morning. So I thought if you can read and I can explain, I would have been happy. So we have finished the chapter. Do you want to ask me any questions?
No.
Have you understood?
Listening.
Because I kept on asking. No one was answering me. I said, hello, can you hear me? Do you understand? No one answered me today. I was shocked. It should not be like this, Bita. Right? Otherwise, you should have told me, ma'am, I'm tired today. So I hope other will take up the charge. No one answered.
Okay.
Should not be like this, okay? fine. Have a good day, beta.
Bye.
I hope you do better in future. Okay? Bye, beta. And you can call me if at all you have any problems, please. Okay? Bye, beta.